So, Dr. Lori, what say you? You think candy lasts until around Christmas time?
I think you need to freeze the candy, but you could always just send it to me. I can take care of it for you.
We hear we need to send it to you because it's a little cold where you're at this morning.
Oh my gosh. I am north of Philadelphia, west of New York City, and it is chilly here. So it's not balmy like in Tampa, but it's always good to be with you guys. And the candy will be good. The candy's good all year long.
I like the philosophy of spacing it out. Well, where do we begin today? Of course, another edition of Dumpster or No Dumpster, $50. That's our mark. Carly and I try to do our best to guess based on the facts you give us. So let's go ahead and begin today.
Thanks to our viewers who are sending objects in. You know, we're still in the Halloween mood, speaking of candy. And this photograph came in from one of our viewers. It's an astronaut Halloween mask, and it has the whole costume. You can see some of the sort of polyester costume with underneath that mask. The mask is plastic, and so is most of the costume, polyester. And basically, it dates to the latter part of the 1960s, early 1970s in its original box. So it was pretty interesting when I saw this on the Facebook page for Tampa Bay's Morning Blend. One of the viewers sent in the picture after Halloween, unfortunately.
Well, I know, because timing's everything. But here's my thing. I feel like in the 70s, you have space, astronaut. I mean, it's still got that kind of going for it. So maybe you hold on for it for maybe another anniversary or something. I don't know. It looks to be in good condition.
Looks to be in great condition in the box. It looks like the outfit, you know, the actual costume was folded up and put in the box, and then the mask on top of it. And they used to have like a clear cellophane on top of those cardboard boxes so you can see through. So they had the whole thing. So, you know, pretty good. I wished we had seen it a couple weeks before, because that would have been the time to sell it when the value would have been a little higher. Does that help you? Dumpster, no dumpster?
Oh, well, the value would be higher. And of course, we're basing it on today. So with that clue, do I go ahead and say dumpster for this one? I don't know.
I know, dumpster now, but no dumpster around Halloween. I don't know. We're for the anniversary. That's not my anniversary.
But we're going C today, Dr. Lori. C, both.
Okay. So basically, all of the above is what you're choosing.
Yes.
Multiple choice. It is a no dumpster, actually. Yeah. It's about $65.
Okay, so it was on the line. So there was a reason why we were struggling
about
with that.
$75 prior to that. This next piece is sent in, and I like the banana in the back.
I love it.
I thought that was great. So it's blue ceramic and gilt cruet set. So basically oil and vinegar, typically. It has a little bit of gold leaf on it, and it has made in Limoges, France. So it's porcelain, blue ground glaze, and then the gilt on top of it. Dates to about the 1940s.
No dumpster. I like that there's two. It looks nice. You said gold. I'm all in.
Said gold. And isn't there some truth too to like blue? I know, isn't like blue
I was thinking that too. Yeah. Blue is very popular. Very popular in ceramics. It dates all the way back to Canton, China, where most of the first ceramics actually came out of. And then they travel all over the world, of course, to Delft and around to France and all over. Value on this, you're absolutely right, ladies. No dumpster, $100 for the pair.
Yeah. Doing well, moving right along, Lori. What do we have last?
Okay, so another ceramic. This one is hand-painted. And speaking of faraway places, this was painted and made in Italy, southern Italy, Naples. It's a piece of Capodimonte. It's an urn. Most people would use it as a planter. They put a plant in it. It has bas-relief, and then the bas-relief figures, they're textural bas-relief, and then they are hand-painted as well. Dates to about the 1960s.
Is that a piece that's with it there in the corner?
There are other pieces in the corner, but you're only looking at the urn planter, which is about 15 inches tall.
Planter. I know that name. I've heard you talk about that name before. But that also means that it's popular, right? There's quite a few of these out there, no?
Quite a few Capodimonte urns out there, yes, from the 1960s. It was a very popular style then, with the little cherubs going all the way around. And bas-relief, it's a textural. You could feel sort of the up and down of it.
Yeah, no dumpster. I think I'm going.
Because of the name, I could be wrong, but I'm going to say no dumpster as well.
It's no dumpster. It's a 150. Yeah. The real question is it your style? And that's what most people make a decision on. It's like, oh, it's garish. I don't like it. But in this particular case, that's a no dumpster too at 150. So nice. Nice going, ladies.
All right.
All no
dumpster. Dr. Lori, you stay warm. send us a little bit of the cold weather, will you? Just a little bit.
I'll do what I can. I'll trade places with you guys any day.
Well, you can get more Dr. Lori. And again, she does all sorts of fun stuff like this on her YouTube channel, her website as well. So we look forward to seeing you again next week, Dr. Lori.
I'll always show you what to look for so you can make big money with your art, antiques, and collectibles.
Love it.